Hi, welcome to This Week at Interface. As always, I'm Ralph.
I'm Lynn.
And we have a ton of stuff going on this week, so let's jump right
in. So we got Mark Thomas is in-house doing ITIL 200. Listen in to Mark for a second.
Specific type. What we mean by that is my service desk, for example. My service desk is not a process. ITIL calls it a function.
So obviously, you've got a really good shot of Mark. And he's doing board work right behind him. A little hard to see that board, and you see the transition to the cameras.
Excellent.
It's as simple as going full screen right there.
Much easier to see.
Exactly.
You can't read it, though.
Well, his handwriting, you know.
Might leave a little to be desired.
But we can get past that.
What is ITIL, Lynn? What does that do?
Well, ITIL doesn't do anything. It's not like Windows Server 2012 where it's going to run your enterprise exchange or messaging. ITIL is a framework. And, you know, we'll look right here, Mark's writing on the board, but within the ITIL information technology infrastructure library, you've got the service strategy, service design, service transition, service operation. So it's really for IT shops to manage the processes in order to keep their enterprise servers or their enterprise services that they offer to the organization up and running.
And the reason I ask that is normally you guys see us teaching specific things like server classes, Cisco classes. These are not that type of class.
These fall into our business services. So
right.
ITIL, business analysis, project management, everything that sort of wraps around the technologies to keep the technologies up and running.
Excellent.
Keep them humming. So let's
So speaking of a technical class.
Yeah, so Mark Jacob has ICND2, the second week of CCNA. Obviously remote. Mark was just coming off break, so I don't know if he's talking or just working here, but we'll jump in and listen and then get a good view of what he's doing behind him.
Looks like he's still setting up.
So, but he obviously you can see him. He's doing some board work. Let's see what he's doing here.
Nice, building a configuration of some sort.
Right. So, you know, as a remote student, you have the option to kind of, you know.
What if I wanted to ask Mark a question? How would I do that as a remote
student?
Right.
So you're on break. Mark's setting something up. You're watching. It's as simple as clicking on this microphone here up in the top of the screen. As a remote student, we send you microphones, we send you all your course material, the whole kit.
So I don't need anything.
Right, so you sit there and just as if you were a student in the classroom, you can ask Mark a question even when you're on break. So
great.
It's as close to being here as we can get it. Looks like we've got Jason Helmick. Jason might have gone on break. Listen in.
Change. Permanently.
Even three
did it too. Yeah.
Right. So Jason's talking about some knowledge base articles.
Got it.
You can clearly see that. You can see what the URL is.
So any software you put on an exchange box, make sure it's for you.
And definitely last but not least, always entertaining.
Spike
X is doing the SharePoint designer.
I understand the commandlets, the things that it needs to know to work with SharePoint.
So you can see the board behind Spike moving, but again,
I do that one right here. I can just right-click this, run as administrator, and it opens up the SharePoint management shell, which, by the way, is supposed to open as administrator by default, but for some reason I haven't found 100% consistency there, so
like
I always right-click to run as administrator.
But if you don't need to look at Spike, if you don't need to see the instructor, you can go full screen on a board. If he's in lecture mode, like Mark was in the snippet we showed of him, it's as simple as going back.
And the other thing to point out, too, as a remote student, you get an actual PC in the classroom. We'll send you a link with Go to My PC information so that if you're doing one of these labs with SharePoint, you get stuck, you need Spike's help, hit that microphone button, say, hey, Spike, I need some help. He'll actually walk over to the PC that you're logged into and be able to assist you.
Absolutely, right. As always, our website. So if you've got Any questions on the remote live? And this is interfacett.com. Just click on the remote live link. If you want to see what schedules we've got up and running, go to course schedule. And if you're looking specifically to see if a class is remote, look for the little R right here on the date.
But if you don't see the R, you can just give us a call because we may be able to change some things around and offer that class remotely for you. Of our 12 classrooms, four of them currently are configured for remote delivery.
Exactly. 602-266-8585. Feel free to give us a call. Always happy to, one of our friendly staff will help you through. As always, follow us on Twitter, Interface TT. All of our blog postings, you know, information from our instructors, some fun photos. So this was a really popular post over the weekend. Remember when computers were fun? PowerShell can get you back to having fun with your computer.
Exactly.
So, speaking of getting back, we need to get back to work. Yeah. It's always great seeing
you. Pleasure. We'll see you next week.
Be safe.